shaking. I told Tommy, I said, we're gonna get one right here. So I'm gonna go into some locating sounds. Do what's it called, interrogation out. Ready, Tommy? Ready? Here we go. Set up as a decoy out into the field. Use an electronic collar this evening. See, we got this fence right here. Really trying to keep my scope dry right now. Said that it's supposed to break till about 11 o'clock tonight, then come back in. So I'm trying to slip out and get a set in right before dark. It's legal here in Indiana to hunt after dark, which is what we do a lot of times to avoid deer hunters. So I didn't get a response right off the bat. Just gonna give it a minute here. Gonna change the howl up a little bit. Gonna switch to a female, just kinda like answering the other one. Normally I would wait 4 to 5 minutes before switching to a different howl. But today, stress for time before it gets dark. About a minute going to female owl. Some good footage here. So I've got Tommy watching. I'm kind of covering the back door. Wind's coming out of the north. So I'm watching the downwind side. Walked up on a couple deer when we walked in here. Response. Gonna switch to a distress call. Gonna turn the sound down. Thank you. saw one up on the hill over here. So I walked up on these two does when I was setting out the decoy, Mojo Critter. Tommy just told me they're still standing there. I've got the electronic collar about 40 yards from them. Blazing out a rabbit in distress proves my point, guys. Coyote hunting does not affect deer hunting. How you doing? I made a post the other night about it. About seeing some deer. What? Deer just took off. That's a good sign. I'm gonna try to get the camera over there. That's a good tip for you guys starting out. Watch these animals, pay attention to them. Listen to them, listen to the birds. Birds will cue you off 10 out of 10 times about an approaching predator. Coyotes and foxes, birds go berserk. Crows. Crows are a dead giveaway. Deer's the same way. Coyote coming in, deer checking out. If I'm out here not filming and I'm watching the back door, I've got my rifle pointed to where I think a coyote may check up downwind, so I'm ready for him, but I also carry a shotgun with me too. I'd have the shotgun posted up right back here watching this fence line, so I'm doing things a little different. I'm gonna tell Tommy to go ahead and break out the light just so we can pick up those eyes that you might not be able to see right now. Out. Hulk Hogan tried to tell. You're sitting right there with the caller. Wind's coming from that direction. So I'm watching the opposite direction, which is the downwind side. So I'm playing cleanup, watching the back door. Any coyotes that want to ride in the back of a pickup truck are going to try back, sneak back here and get past me. That ain't happening. Ain't nobody got time for that. I'm going to switch the sounds up now. I've been running the distress call about 5 minutes. I'm going to switch to coyote distress. See what happens. I'm not going to pause the call. I'm not going to go right into the distress. Some guys will pause it. They'll scroll through and then not be able to find the sounds. Here we go. Starts to get dark out here. I'm gonna have to get my light on my person. As I've been taking a break from shining, I've been laying this light on my lap like so. What it does is it still projects a light that can be seen continuously for 500 feet, according to the laws from the state of Indiana. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and throw on my headlight. I'm going to apologize for that because I know that was some bad footage. So now I'm multitasking. All right, I'm gonna switch up sounds. Go to a more aggressive coyote distress. No response here. It's still kind of drizzling rain, which I'm sure has a big effect on everything this evening. So what I'm going to do now before we lose light is I'm going to do some more howling, and we're going to call it a set. since we've been sitting here about 15 minutes, no response. We haven't seen anything, which I'm thinking the rain is playing a big factor in that. I don't hunt in the rain. Like I said, we got a little break and snuck out here. So they should be moving or just getting ready to move. What we're gonna do, we're gonna go quiet for 3 or 4 minutes while we're shining, and then we'll move on to the next set. And the reason that is about the being quiet part, there may be something coming. You don't want to get up too soon. Give these coyotes and foxes time to get here, which we're targeting coyotes right now. Give them time to get here. Some of them might stop and catch a snack on the way. Grab a mouse. Grab a mouseketeer. 3 mouseketeer bar. Mojo's still working over there. So guys, what we're gonna do, we're gonna move on to the next set. Hopefully bring y'all some action. If this rain stops, if not, we're gonna have to catch it another day. Stay tuned, give us a like. We're gonna bring you lots of action this year, lots of funny scenarios, hopefully teach you something.